Hello, everybody. Redgamemaster here.
All primary systems online.
Just logged back in after having done a little bit of work on the base that we made here. Hold on one second. That audio is... sound is higher than it should be. There we go, that should do. So, as I said, I did a little bit of work on the base in between last episode and this. As you guys can tell, I got power going. Let me show you what I did for that. I basically got 3 solar panels installed. You know, that's still sounding a little bit loud. Let me turn it down a bit more. There we go, that's better.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
So yeah, I did a little bit of running around. I made a fabricator, so we don't have to keep... so I don't have to keep running back to our little life pod. I made an indoor grow bed and went and got some seeds. See? Lantern fruit. And that is nearly grown, so that'll be nice for us. I also added in our bioreactor here. One of the reasons... dang it, I keep doing that. One of the reasons for that is because this lantern tree, once it's fully grown, will not only give us lots of food, but apparently lantern fruits are actually quite good when it comes to this. When it comes to a bioreactor. I also made a large cabinet, which I used to basically take everything that I had back at my base, back there at the life pod, and bring it here. That way it's all in a central area. Now, there are a few things. I also made myself some disinfected water, because although salt seems to be fairly common here, down there on the ground, you guys can already see a few pieces down there. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bladderfish are not, but that's okay because salt, and then we have some normal coral here, which gives us plain coral. Let's see, something else I did, or I found while I was out, is I found all the parts that I need for the Cyclops bridge, so, and I also found a few pieces for the hull. And I found the other piece that I need for a battery charger. I do want to try and make that, but I can't right now because I don't have the silver for the computer chip. While I was out, I did find a few wrecks, I mean. So let's see if we can't find those again. I'll be back once I actually get to one of them. Ooh. Here's one of the escape pods. What do you say? Oh, he's a little bit scary, but let's get in here and see what we can find. Compass. It looks like that's it. So, let's see. This compass will actually be fairly useful. It goes in one of these two slots, so we'd have to take out one of those to use it, but it gives us a north, south, east, and west navigation. Alright, I'm gonna keep exploring around. I think it's actually just over this ridge here, so maybe I won't be cutting right away. Oh, I thought so. Oh, no, there it is. It was on the ridge, not just over it. So yeah, this is where I found the battery charger piece, and as you guys can see, there's another one right there. So there's a few of them here. And looks like we're starting to find the larger deposits like that one right there for the silicon. I can't remember exactly what they are. Ooh. Oh, you guys don't look nice. Alright, well, since we're here, Why don't we try exploring this a little bit? I want to try and... Ah, that looks like a good entrance. Disinfected water. Another battery charger fragment. There's another one. Oh, jeez. Die, you little bugger. Follow me in here. Nothing in there. Alright, then let's open this up. Let's see what's behind door number one. More battery charger fragments. Some plants. Ah, still suit fragment. Still suit is actually quite useful because it... Well, I'll give you guys a better idea of what it does later.
30 seconds.
Oh, only 30 seconds of oxygen left. Ooh. Natural selection. Let's take that one. I know that game, but I don't know much about the people who worked on this one. So are they the same people, or... Alright, oxygen is refilled. And I actually missed this last time. What is this? Oh, just another stillsuit fragment, huh? Okay, and that's the back entrance we saw. Can't get in through there. What about this? This looks like a door that can be cutted, but yeah, I don't have a laser cutter. So that's gonna be a bit of a problem. Luckily, we should be heading to the place where I will be able to get the last piece that I need for a laser cutter today. Just want to check the rest of this place, make sure that I'm not missing something major. No? Alright. Okay. I also placed down a beacon near our base so that I don't have to worry about losing it. And I nearly lost it like two or three times as I was going back and forth from the floating island to the base to get the resources I needed. I'm going to actually check because we're going to need some food soon, so maybe that lantern fruit tree is fully grown. Those stilts do bother me a little bit, I will admit. Okay. And how's our lantern fruit tree doing? Huh? It's growing, but not much. Oh, I keep forgetting that. Alright, I keep forgetting it's right-click to put stuff in. No, can't go there. How about right there? Natural selection 2. So, I guess you guys will probably have to tell me if that's the same people. Because I honestly do not know. Hold on. I want to see... Do I have resources? Enough resources to make... No, I need quartz for that and I need glass for that. Alright. I might do a quick run to try and get some quartz so that I can empty out my... inventory a little bit more before I get going. So, I'll be back in a little bit once I've got some quartz. Oh, I actually forgot. When I loaded up the game, when I was getting everything ready, for some reason, one of the reef backs was stuck here in the shallows. Don't know why, he's just kind of stuck here and he hasn't been able to make his way out. I think the main problem is that their tentacles don't have collision, but their bodies do, and his body keeps hitting, so. Alright guys, I'm back. Just making up some glass so that I can make this second locker. We go. Actually, you guys... Well, that's gonna bother me if I don't fix that right now. There we go. It's a little thing, but it can be quite annoying, at least to me. Okay. Gonna need that power cell. You can go back. Oh, no. Alright, I'm gonna take a med kit with me. I'm actually gonna take two, because I need to use one right now. And I guess the rest of this stuff will have to go in here. Not gonna need that fire extinguisher quite yet. And that. I'm actually going to take those out and put that in. Because see that gives us the thing on the top. And because I already have one of those in there. There we go. No, there we go. And now everything is nice and neat and organized. I've got quite a bit of water, some nutrient block, and a med kit. And the reason I needed to grab that power cell is because I'm actually running a little bit low on power for this baby. Hopefully I can find myself a moon pool soon. I'm going to head up to the surface to make sure that we're heading the right way. I think it should be over this way. I do need to be careful because near the broken end of the ship is a Leviathan, so. But then again, near the place we're going is a Leviathan or two, so. It's all a little bit of a risk. Alright, I'll be back once we get there. Okay, we're almost there. You can see the gigantic gun of the station. There we go. We're gonna want to land right about in that area. The ocean was sounding really scary there for a second. Starting to lose it. Yeah, I know, there's a message for me back at the pod, but I don't want to have to go back to the pod anymore, so I'm trying to actually make a thing. There's the sea dragon, or just the sea leviathan that I was telling you guys about. Getting out. Placing power cell, because I'm going to need that on my way back. No. I was so unnerved. Just, I'm really on edge. I'm jumping. I just jumped at that bush because I thought it was too close. Oh my gosh. Okay, knife out. Looks like they put some large deposits on the surface of this island now, too. That's cool. Alright, I have 75 food, and I've got quite a bit of water, so I should be good. Oh no, I already have scanned artifacts. Okay. That's right. Okay, so, actually, first thing we're going to do, or I guess first I'll scan this, because it says I still need to scan it for some reason. Before we go in there, the thing that I came here to get, not gold, I came here to get diamonds, because I need it. Because I need them, or I need one at least, in order to be able to make that cutter that I need. So. And there should be some in the caverns here. Oh, you're infected. Don't want to deal with you ugly suckers. Jeez, you guys are just everywhere. Oh, hey, what's this? Ooh, reinforced dive suit. Hey, that reminds me, I never showed you guys what the still dive suit was, did I? Okay.
Caution. Dehydration detected.
Oh, okay, so apparently those are two of one. I just didn't notice that before.
Vital signs.
There we go. Just leave me alone, and I'll leave you guys alone. Okay, you ain't gonna leave me alone. And my... It's the looking... Ah! Hey! Die! For some reason, I've got a knife wiener now. Switch to that. That's even worse. That's even worse than knife wiener. Diamond. Remember that materials you gather are the property of Altera Corporation. Use of these resources for survival is sanctioned, but you will be liable to reimburse the full market value. Your current bill stands at $658,000. Jeez. Lots of salt here. Oh, another one. Another purple artifact. Cool. So I guess that means I've got two? I thought I had three. Did I not take that one with me I wanted to take? Probably not. That's usually what happens. Why am I still going up? Why aren't I going back down? More gold, although silver is more what I need. Wow, that place is pretty darn rich. Alright, let's see what we got. Just more gold. Ah, another diamond. Good. Let's grab some of this lithium while we're here. We're gonna need it. Oh, and look what we found. Come here, I'm gonna hit you with my knife wiener. Oh, get back here. Are you dead? Alright, well. Oh, that's this. Unfortunately, I do not have a fuel crystal, but we will in a little bit. Let's scan this. I do not know why that is happening. Alien structure. This structure's intended purpose is unclear. Possible theories, ceremonial or religious role, industrial applications, advanced transportation network. That's the one. I know that for sure. It may be prudent to search the area for further examples of alien architecture and technology. You know, let's see if I do this. No, it still messes up.
Performing self-scan. Foreign bacteria counters reached statistically significant levels. No adverse effects detected. Caution. Be vigilant for symptoms. Decreasing calorie intake recommended.
And that is why I brought
this. Vital signs stabilizing.
So yeah, we've got a few diamonds. We got ourselves some lithium, which is needed for plasteel. All of these are minerals that are usually found quite a bit lower, but because this place actually used to be underground and is actually a large volcano-like thing. Oh, that's not good. Don't die on... Oh, that almost ended badly. Okay, I gotta find, I guess at this point it'd probably be best to find my way around the island. What is that? Looks like something a space creature would come out of. Knife wiener. Running away, I'm just trying to get through. Dang it. Oh, jeez. Die. Okay. No more knife wiener. Alright, I guess I gotta run around. I will see you guys in a little bit. Oh, no. I guess that this island wasn't as big as I thought it was. That's what she said. Here we are. Might as well scan it first, even though our scanner isn't working right. This device appears to be alien in origin and is connected up to a nearby force field. The technology is far beyond anything encountered before by the Federation. Nonetheless, it appears to function like a normal lock. It only needs the correct kind of key, which we have two of. Which is a good thing because we're going to need a second one with Sprint there. So, put that away. How are we doing on space? Yeah, we're pretty good. And we've got... Scans indicate the structure is composed of a metal alloy with unprecedented integrity. No matches found in database performing structural analysis. The sun is setting. Identified a background message being broadcast throughout the facility. Partial translation available. Message reads... Warning. Unidentified craft in orbit of this planet will be destroyed. Prevent the... Well, I guess it did say partial. Oh, come on. Analysis of the patterns on the wall cannot ascertain whether their purpose is aesthetic or functional. Further data required. Alright, data terminal. Unknown language. Oh. Thank you, Jessica. This terminal was discovered within the alien facility on... Yeah, on the surface of 4546B. On approach, the terminal began producing a low-frequency radio wave containing complex but recognizable data patterns. Matches no known technologies, constructed from the same off-world material as the facility itself. Seems to be a solid-state computer of some kind, no recognizable user interface. It is likely the alien species which designed this technology evolved or genetically selected sensory apparatus to hear and understand the information being broadcast by the device and to communicate back. The metal processing power required to perform this kind of I have no mental processing power, but apparently they did. To perform this kind of telepathy would imply the designers are considerably more psychologically developed than the common human. Using the evidence gathered from this device, it may be possible to extract comprehensible data from other such devices, should they exist. Yeah, that's nothing. Best probability of interfacing with this facility is achieved by accessing the control room in the lower section. Ah, and here's one of the ion crystals. Let's give it a quick scan. There we go. Cool. Where is that? It was in planetary geology. Ion crystals. These alien cubes each store the equivalent energy of a small nuclear detonation. The alien technology is able to keep the stored atoms in a permanently stable state. However, under right conditions, the reaction could be recatalyzed and an energy released in a controlled manner. They were likely used as batteries, storing power generated at the main reactor and then transported wherever they were needed. Assessment: possible source of escape velocity energy? Possibly, but I'm pretty sure I don't want to be sitting on an exploding nuke when that happens, so that's probably not a good idea. Let's take another water. Ah, here's another ion crystal. And another data terminal. This data set appears to be a multi-dimensional schematic of some kind. By mapping the pattern to three-dimensional space, it is possible to gather a basic understanding of the facility's internal workings, which may help identify a way to disable it. Construction material. The facility's unknown construction material is identified as an ultra-hard, non-reactive metal amalgam, synthesized from off-world materials. There is no indication that it can be damaged or destroyed by known means. Power. The schematic indicates the facility was to be powered by a separate self-sustaining power plant located elsewhere on the planet. The location is not listed, but there is evidence the designers intended to harness the power's natural thermal energy. So, active lava zone. Layout. The facility consists of an upper engineering section where this schematic was found in the control room, which is accessed via a security-sealed elevator shaft or a separate underwater moon pool. Not the moon pool we need. Control. The control room in the lower section houses the only known way to interface with the facility. However, the schematic does not detail the operation procedure or installed security measures. Okay. Well, here's the elevator. Can you imagine if we had elevators like this? It would just, to me, that would just blow my mind every time I went into it. Although, to be completely honest, a cell phone blows my mind, everyone. The fact that I have a cell phone, basically a miniature computer in my hand, blows my mind every once in a while. So, alright, there's the other purple artifact. There this goes. And in the future, we will be able to use that, because now that is open, to come in through here. Okay. Okay, I know that there should be maybe probably a few more ion crystals around here somewhere. Ah, there's one. Before I go up, what is down here? Ah, another portal thingy. But you don't have a pedestal. Are you meant to be... Yeah, I think that this one is meant to connect to the other facility, but I don't think the developers have implemented that yet. Either that, or it needs to be connected from the other facility, which actually would make sense lore-wise as well. So if that's what they're going for, good job, guys. Right, no ion crystal over there. Alright, I'm going to head up, and I will see you guys once I am at the top. Just for future reference, there's another purple artifact here. Which, it looks like that's a very good thing, because it looks like we needed a third one to get in here. I don't remember that. Scans indicate the facility's control room lies beyond this doorway. Oh, it's a good thing that they just so happen to keep a third purple artifact around so that we can get in. Alrighty. Lots of pillars and creepy looking stuff. Alright, well then this must be it. Disable facility. That's not good. Ah! Yeah, that hurt. Warning, infected individuals may not disable the enforcement system. This planet is under quarantine.
Warning, infected individuals may not disable the weapon. This planet is under quarantine.
Alright, I'm just just going to scan that and see if that gives us anything. I don't think it did. Massive energy readings from this structure indicate it is the main reactor.
Indicate the presence of a second facility elsewhere on the planet. Evidence suggests it is located 800 meters below sea level, approximately 1 kilometer southwest of this installation. Information recorded to data bank.
Well, that's everything that we could get from here. So I guess that is it for now, everyone. And next time I see you guys, we will be back at the base, and then we can start getting into some of the more cool stuff. There we go. There's the disease research facility thing. So I guess this is it for today. Well, everyone, that's it for today. As always, leave a like, and please subscribe if you'd like to see more. And, of course, leave a comment with any suggestions you have or something that might help me in the future. So, once again, I wish you all have a wonderful day.